shift into 5D now. This is available to us right now. A lot of people are stuck in 3D. Why are you stuck in the fear-based reality? Get out of fear. Choose love. I mean, it's just that simple. Don't complicate it. Get out of your head. Jump into the heart. Live life. Gosh, I'm gonna explain to you the difference between 3D, 4D, and 5D. There's a lot of confusion going on all over the internet. I wanna really simplify this for you and get you to understand what 5D consciousness is and how to embody it. A lot of people are stuck in 3D because of fear. Think about it as simple as this. 3D is fear and 5D is love. 4D is what connects the two together. You have to go through 4D to enter 5D. 4D is like a gateway to 5D. They all exist simultaneously. It's not like you can only be in 3D, only be in 4D, or only be in 5D. And guess what? There's other dimensions too. First, I guess I should explain the word dimension. A lot of people get confused with the word dimension. It's not like some alien world where all these celestial beings are going to come down and start communicating with you. A dimension is a state of consciousness. It's a state of being. It's not a place. It's somewhere you actually go to. It's an expansion of your consciousness. It's not a physical place like when you travel on an airplane. This is something that is beyond our body. The 4D realm is tied to the astral realms. This is where we go when we sleep. Everyone experiences this at night when DMT is leaked through the pineal gland and we exit our body, allowing us to travel through the astral realm. There is no gravity. There is no time. There is no space. There are different set of laws that govern each dimension. 3D is the most physical material world. We need it. It's everywhere around us. It's tied to the matrix grid. Without it, there would be no world. There would be no plants, no animals, nothing. So don't say that 3D is bad or good, because that's being stuck in duality, which is 3D. We have to get beyond all of that and simply live in the now. That is what 5D consciousness truly is, living in the now. When you recognize that there is no past, there is no future, the only thing that is real is the present moment. That is what 5D is all about, embodying that frequency so we can all rise up together and experience higher consciousness on planet Earth. If you're stuck in fear, if you're constantly worrying about things, and if you're agreeing with that negative belief, that thought that is telling you and pushing you down all the time, that's being stuck in 3D. You have to open your consciousness, expand your consciousness through many techniques such as yoga, meditation, organic food, sun gazing, fasting, soaking up the sunshine, getting out in nature, grounding yourself. There are endless techniques to help get you out of that 3D physical dense reality. Once you experience that effortless, that weightlessness, that euphoria, that's you slowly letting go of the 3D based reality. Anytime you get stuck in fear, anytime you get stuck in worry, trap, guilt, resentment, you're getting sucked right back into 3D. You're getting sucked down into that lower vibration. 4D is the plane. Think of it like the vessel that carries you to 5D. It is something that is first experienced like in a glimpse, and you wake up from the dream. You're like, whoa, did that really happen? Did I really experience that? Where was I? Who am I? These are the questions that you're going to start to ask yourself when you start awakening to that higher 5D consciousness. A lot of things start feeling a little funny. The logical mind gets a little woo-woo. Things get a little, crazy, as they say. You might call yourself crazy, and that's exactly what's happening, and it's completely normal because we need a little bit of crazy. We need to get outside of the logical mind. We need to get out of all these rational thoughts that are keeping us in that lower vibration. Again, expand your consciousness. Open up to this higher vibratory field that is available to us right now on planet Earth. This all comes down to your daily practice, constantly refining that daily practice to uplift your consciousness, letting go of the things that no longer serve you, setting that chakric boundary in the third chakra and saying, you know what, this isn't going to work anymore. I'm only accepting things that are increasing my vibration, and allowing things to constantly come into your field, process your emotions, and upgrade to the next level. It's not like you just have this instant kundalini, like, oh, lightning bolt to the third eye and everything's, you know, rainbows and butterflies. It's just not how it works like that. This is a daily practice. You have to really put this into a routine to show the universe that you're leading by example. This isn't going to happen in the logical, in the place where you only happen through idea. This happens through direct action, getting you into the place where that 5D consciousness really exists. Start with your environment. Start with what you can control in your life. The food that you eat, the air that you breathe, the environment that you're in, you can control that. Increase everything in your environment to raise your frequency. Hang artwork on your walls that are high vibration. Wear colors of you know, clothes that you want to increase your vibration. Wear things that are going to make you alive, make you excited about being alive. If you're in this lower vibrational field, you are the only one that can get yourself out. And this is a warning too. I want to warn everybody before we go any further, because 5D, once you enter 5D, you can't go back. A lot of people ask me, oh, what's 5D all about? How do I get there? Blah, blah, blah. You cannot go back. You have to remember that once you're in the heart, once you're fully loving life, it's impossible to go back to those mind games and the manipulation and all the duality and all the gunky stuff that's in 3D. And I'm not saying that like it's bad or good. I'm just telling you that once it happens, it happens. And you have to own it. You have to completely own that vibration and walk around and practice like what you preach. There are things that are going to constantly test you with this. As soon as you start watching videos like this, as soon as you start increasing your vibration, the universe is going to send you all kinds of things to help you wake up. The universe always gives you what you want. The universe is always testing us and giving us something to give us the opportunity to grow, to give us the opportunity to ascend to the next level. Are you ready? Are you answering the call? Are you listening to the messages that the universe is presenting to you every single day? Or are you just swiping up on social media? Are you looking at TV all the time? Are you trapped in that dense physical reality? I see all levels of this 24/7 with people, and you have to really understand that your higher self is like trying to pull you into this higher frequency every single moment. The higher self, all your guides, all the angels, everybody in these higher dimensions are just looking at you and saying, come on, bro, let's do this. I want you to be here. Come with me, please. You are such a beautiful soul. I want you to experience this high vibration. All you have to do is let go of what you think works. Drop all of that logic and step into your heart. The rational mind is not going to be happy with this. There's going to be some friction. There's going to be a place in time where you're going to be uncomfortable. The only way out is through. That upgrade is lying right on the other side of your fears. That gift that you were experiencing that you would call a trauma is going to be there forever until you get through it. Have the courage to get through it. That's where the self-care comes in. That's where the food, the organic food, your meditation practice, taking a nice hot bath, doing things that are going to really rejuvenate you on that cellular level. Things that are going to get you so courageous and make you feel so good that you actually have the courage to face these things. Otherwise, they're just going to keep recreating into your life for you to learn that lesson again. That trauma, that thing that happened in the first place, is just going to get recreated by a different person to give you, again, the opportunity to grow and shift out of 3D. It's right here. It's available to you. The question is, are you answering the questions? Are you looking at all of those puzzle pieces the universe is giving you and putting it together? You are the only one that can do this. There's a very unique situation wrapped up in a package for you. Just open it. It's like Christmas. Start tearing that paper out. Get all excited about it. When you start doing that, the universe is going to constantly just give you more gifts to unwrap, more lessons to learn. This is an endless process. It's a daily practice. What do you do when you're enlightened? What do you do when you're in 5D? What do you do when you've already accomplished all the goals that you've ever accomplished in your life? You still have to chop the wood and carry the water. That means going back to the regular things that everybody does. It's not like you just sit on top of a mountain and meditate all day and everybody else just catches up with you in that higher consciousness. That's just not how it works. We are in a new frame of consciousness that is centered in 5D, that is centered around love. Start loving life. Start creating the change within you. Start seeing where you're being affected. Where are you being triggered? Where are those blocks? Where are those energetic blocks in your life that you feel stuck at? Focus on those things that are keeping you trapped in that lower vibratory field. Only then, when you start literally, I mean, for me, I had to write them all down. I had to really get into a meditative state and start asking myself, where did this come from? 80% of it wasn't even for me. A lot of it came from past lives, other people, other traumas, things that I've actually gathered from into my being that I'm holding on to that I had to let go of before I could rise to 5D, before I could get into higher consciousness. You have to examine what is holding you back. That is really the work that a lot of people aren't willing to do. That inner work that needs to be done, that only you can do. Nobody can do this for you. There's no recipe. There's no simple thing. There's no pill. There's no nutrition. There's nothing that can really speed this up but your own willpower and determination. That is it. So whatever that thing that gives you more willpower and determination, keep doing that. Keep doing more of that. The more courage you have, the more clarity on what you are manifesting, the more energy you have within your being is going to keep you on track every single day. And then you're just in the high vibe tribe. Then you're just here loving life and just happy to be here. Everything is a blessing. Everything is meant to be. There are no coincidences. There are no mistakes. It's all perfect. How could you question the universe? How could you even have a thought that something is quote unquote wrong? It's not possible. It's not. When you're centered in 5D, everything is perfect. There are no mistakes. You don't even question it anymore. You acknowledge why it happened, what you learned, integrate it, and then wait for the next upgrade. It's just that simple. Why complicate it even any more than that? Just live life. The meditative state that you need to get into is key here. What's called the witness mode, the observer mode. I'm not saying let go. I'm not saying spiritual bypass everything. A lot of people get, you know, that mistake when I say let go or when I say witness or observer. I'm not telling you to spiritual bypass. I'm not telling you to forget everything and avoid everything. The only way out is through direct action. Getting through those limitations is going to prepare you for that upgrade. That's just how it works. All you have to do is take action. Really bring yourself into that place where you have the courage to take the action to get to the next level. You can do this. I promise you, it's right there. Have a little faith. It'll go a long way. Peace. Infinite love. I'm out.